What's good, people? It's Deitrick Haddon, Clarita's blood brother, baby. Keep it locked right here with Blue Flame Moment for the best in all of gospel music, you heard?
Well, it's about time for our indie spotlight, and I have an amazing guest with me. Why don't you help me welcome Mr. Micah, the voice, Lee. Hey, Micah.
Hey, Clarita, how you doing?
I'm doing well. I'm so excited to have you back. The last time you were with us, you were being featured about, you know what, I really enjoyed telling your story. You have an amazing testimony, but God is doing something new in your life right now. You are back and you're doing something else. I'm just excited to talk to you. So let's talk about what you got going on. You have some brand new Christmas music.
Yes, we have some brand new music. I have a brand new single. It's called "Tis the Season," and it's available everywhere right now.
Well, you know, Micah, I want to make sure that the people that are listening remember who you represent, what you represent, where you're from. Where are you from, Micah?
I'm from sunny South Florida. I am all the way down at the bottom where we have Christmas. I guarantee it's going to be probably 80 degrees on Christmas Day.
Yeah, well, you know, it's a great big transition for me as well. I'm used to those snowy white Christmases, but I'm having to kind of deal with the issue of no snow. It's a little different for me. I'm over here kind of tripping out, but I'm having a good time. You're used to it. I guess I'll get used to it too. Yes. Well, I love your artwork. It looks amazing. And so I want to tell you congratulations for releasing something good again. And we are excited to always be able to spotlight you, to tell the world about what's going on in the life of Mr. Micah, the voice, Lee. I can't let you leave our indie spotlight without letting everybody know where they can follow you, where they can find this brand new hot Christmas music. So go ahead and tell them.
The brand new single from MicahLee, "Tis the Season," is available everywhere right now on all of your digital platforms. So please go out and support this record. It's MicahLee. It's M-I-C-A-H. Last name Lee.
All right, you heard it straight from his mouth. Check him out, M-I-C-A-H, Micah.
Blue Flame Moments Radio Show.
Your weekly source for inspiration.
With Clarita Haddon Jackson.
And it's time to release the word of the day. Today's word is legacy. Proverbs 13:22. A good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children, and the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. We got to talk about this, y'all. There's not only one way to leave an inheritance. You just have to do a little bit more than other people do. I know that. But let me tell you something. You don't need to just leave it with money. You need to leave it with your name. You need to make sure that what you do is building a foundation for not just your children, but your children's children. I have a quick story. So my father-in-law, Bishop Horace Jackson, tells me a story about his father who worked for Detroit Edison when he was younger. And till this day, if someone with the last name Jackson walks into DTE and say, "I want a job," they automatically give it to them because of that legacy, the work that he did in his time there. So I want you to know that if you leave the right legacy, if you build the right inheritance, your children will be able to live off of it. Your children's children will be able to live off of it. Why don't you help me welcome this man who I know is building a legacy for his children's children, my brother, Deitrick Haddon. What do I do?
My God, that's a word, Clarita. Where can I send my offering to that word?
Well, the Blue Flame Live would be the right place to do it.
You own something.
Yes,
that's
sir.
That's powerful.
Yes, sir. So talk to us about legacy.
I think that's what we're flowing in right now. Yes, and how anointed you are doing what you're doing. How we get up and sing under the anointing. We're not afraid to stand in front of crowds. We're flowing in the legacy that our parents sold into us.
Yes.
You know, and that's why it's not hard for us to do it. But I really feel like the greatest inheritance or legacy that you can leave for your family is a relationship with God.
Woo, that's
the
it.
The greatest. And I think that's why we're able to go on and through tests and trials still stand strong and operate in the anointing that we walk in is because our parents they left a legacy in our hearts towards God. And that's the most important thing. So, you know, you own something today. Go ahead, Clarita. Go on. Preach. Go on and preach.
I'm not going to preach. You're supposed to be preaching. This is an interview with you. So what I want to tell everybody, just in case they don't know, you know, there's some people who don't know what's happening. So I want to tell them that you are the pastor of Hill City Church LA, where the power of God moves every week. Why don't you just tell them a little bit where it is or something? I don't know. Talk about the church.
If you're in LA, the first thing you got to do is look up Hill City Church. Don't go to Hollywood and look at the stars on the ground. Come to the house of God and come check out your boy, Pastor Deitrick Haddon, and First Lady Dominique, and the entire Hill City Church family. Our church is bomb. I love our church. I love pastoring our church. I love speaking to them because they know my heart. They have my DNA. They appreciate the gift of God that's on my life. And the church is growing. And you can come and be a part of it if you are in the Los Angeles area.
Yes, sir. I can agree that it's a great church. I had the privilege of being a part of the ministry during my short stay in Long Beach, California.
You had the privilege of preaching the walls down, Clarita.
No.
You had the privilege of wrecking the church.
No.
And preaching the walls down. Every time she preached, I had to get my church back from her.
Uh-uh.
That's how bad she is.
No. But I did have the opportunity to serve there, and so I'm in agreement that it's a great place to worship in LA. You need to make your way there. So let's talk about this, since you want to keep on telling everybody that you're my brother, and you know, you're not ashamed of that. But talk about how it was growing up in the house. Was I getting on your nerves? I mean, I don't know. I'm just asking.
Let's talk about these cowgirl boots that you could not get rid of. I'm telling you, even if we threw them away, they would find their way back in the house at the door.
No, I'm gonna tell y'all the truth. Dietrich used to put the shoes where I could see them so I could put it on. He wanted me to put them on so he could laugh at church. That's the truth.
That is the truth, because mama would throw them away, then I'd go back and get them and put them back in, because I know it's going to run mama so low. Because Clarita wanted to wear those boots no matter what she had on. She would wear them to school, to church. Those were her boots. And I would say that there was some anointed boots, because every time she got up to sing when she was little, she would wreck the house, you know. And I'm Clarita, so just so everybody would know, I'm Clarita's number one fan. Number one fan. And she can't do no wrong.
Oh, my
Even
God.
Even if she do something wrong, I still hear it as something good. And so you got to have people in your life that you really appreciate and you honor and you respect the gift on their lives. And Clarita's one of those individuals in my life. So y'all handle my Clarita right, and make sure y'all support and spread the word about the Blue Flame Moments. All right, tell them Deitrick Haddon said.
Yes. So I want to talk about, you have a beautiful family. You have beautiful children. I absolutely love them. They are gifted. They are talented. They are anointed. And they're hilarious. So I just want to talk about the kids a little bit. Just a little bit.
We got to figure out how to keep Denver in her own bed, because every morning I wake up, she's right up under me, and I just cannot deal with the Clarita. So you got to tell me what to do. We put her to bed in some kind of way. I just don't understand it, and it's wearing me out, because she will not just sleep next to you. She will push you out of your own bed.
Denver has her own personality. She's like, I don't know, she's a great big person in personality. She's little, but her personality is ginormous. You cannot stop her. She's a freight train on its way and will bully everybody.
Do you hear me? She is controlling everything. She is the bully at the church. She is the mother of, Destin is the mother. She sets everything in order.
That's right.
But Denver is the big spirited, she's the big character. And Bear, he's marching to the beat of his own drum. He's in his own world. So they are hilarious. But, you know, they're a blessing to me. You know, when I look at them, sometimes I almost, my eyes swell up in tears just, you know, looking at them, because I never thought that I would have children, you know, and I set my heart to be okay with that. And then the Lord blessed me. And so sometimes I look at them and I start crying. They'd be like, "What's wrong with you, Daddy? Don't cry. No, no, no." You know, but they don't know that's how much I love them. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Absolutely. So you're always doing something. You're always writing. I mean, I can't keep up. Films, all kind of stuff going on. So I want you to just tell us a little bit. What can we expect from Deitrick Haddon in 2019? Because it's almost 2019.
It is 2019 in my book. I'm already in it in my mind. Just more music and more movies. I have a movie that's set to be released on TV1. It's a made-for-television original film from TV1 called Sins of a Father. That's dropping either in the second quarter or the third quarter of 2019. So we got that locked and loaded and ready to go. So that's that. I've got about 3 contracts sitting in my on my desk, people trying to sign me the deals, and I'm just taking my time and just relaxing. I like the idea that I have my musical freedom, that nobody can tell me what to do and nobody can dictate what song that I should sing or what song that I should write. As a matter of fact, I just decided to partner with Zaytoven and do a Christmas record. And if you know anything about Zaytoven, he's one of the biggest hip-hop producers that's out there right now. They call him the godfather of trap music because he was one of the inventors of it when he was jumping off. So, but he's produced everybody from the Migos to Drake, Usher. We just did the Usher record, and I had the privilege of being able to write 3 songs on his album.
Yes, and that was great. Yes, that was awesome.
I just did something for Chris Brown, and hopefully that's going to drop soon. So I'm really enjoying being able to write and use my gift outside of the four walls of the church. And I love writing my songs for the four walls of the church. And so, you know, I realize that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and the world and they that dwell therein. For years, we've been taught to stay out of there. Don't go out there. Stay within these four walls of this church. You're going to get lost out there. But no, we're mature now. We're spiritually mature. We're learned in the Word of God. And we understand that, hey, the world belongs to God, and all we have to do is take it by force and don't let the world system get in our hearts. Stay holy in our hearts.
That's right.
But go out there and reach the world. Mm-hmm.
So tell me this. I know when we were working on projects that were outside of church, we caught so much flack. And people were leaving the church and said, we can't be under your leadership. You're making music. You're doing this and that. And I want to know, has it affected you, the ministry, the people that follow you, even online? You know, how has it been with you being a part of these other projects?
I think there's always going to be some people that just don't get it because we live in a very religious, starchy, traditional culture.
Exactly, yes.
So, but I'm not here. I can't dumb myself down to accommodate your small way of thinking. I got to live my life and tell my story. At the end of the day, my story will be read, and it won't be said that Deitrick didn't do what God called him to do to accommodate people.
Yes. I'm quite sure that people are changed by it. There's people that are experiencing God through it, even though you may not be, you know, in some of the songs that you write, you may not be talking about God or anything like that. But the anointing on your life, the grace on your life, it always transfers. So in my experience, it transfers. Have you been getting testimonies about transfers?
Absolutely. And the people that I pastor, they love me. And they take, I take these moments as for ministry moments for them, to teach them the Word of God. You know, I don't do anything outside of the Word of God, period. That's one thing that I have. My foundation is laid, and I'm not veering from the foundation. However, there are different methods that you can use to reach this generation, and you have to in order to connect and make the gospel relevant.
Right.
You know, so I'll do something like make a love song so people that love songs can to check for me. And then when they get to know who I really am, they get to know about Jesus Christ.
Absolutely.
So I believe in putting the right bait on the hook to catch a particular group of fish. I believe in that.
Yes,
you know?
Sir.
And so my church is growing as a result because I stay ahead of it. Like, you know, like I'm an actor, and so this movie that's coming out is really edgy. I'm playing a preacher who burned down his church, that slept with people in the church, and killed his wife. I'm playing this crazy character, but I take this opportunity to teach our church and to do ministry in an unorthodox way, because at the end of the day, this is a true story. This is what really happened, and there are people that are wounded by bad leadership, and this gives me a chance to show people how ugly it looks, you know. And so, and that's what you call unorthodox ministry.
Yes.
And so a lot of people are not assigned to do that. Like people like you and me, you Blue Flame, you're unorthodox. You have the anointing and the grace to be who you are and get results. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
A lot of people get caught up on the method of how you do things, but you shouldn't get caught up on the method as long as you're getting the results. People had a problem with Jesus spitting on the ground and putting mud in somebody's
eye. I know that's right. I know that's right. Yes.
But who cares if the man can see?
That's right. He opened his eyes and he could see. And I think that people get caught up in what they feel tradition is, what they feel religion is, and they forget that we are believers in a Christ who was nothing. It was nothing traditional about him. When people were traditional,
right.
he turned over the tables. He talked about them.
Right.
He said, "You're uncircumcised. You don't even believe the way you're supposed to believe. You think you believe." You think you know me, but you don't even know me. You don't know my father, you know. So I think that people need to get a better understanding, a clearer vision. They need a revelation. If people would walk in revelation of the truth of the Word of God, they would not have the mindset that they have. And I believe that people like you and other people in the industry that are being willing to branch out, to push, to show people another perspective are very vital in this day that we're living in. So congratulations on everything that is happening, on each and every opportunity that God is presenting for you to be a kingdom ambassador to change the lives of believers. So I want to talk about this Christmas project a little bit more, because this is you know, it's the Christmas season. The greatest gift. Let's talk about this project. It's got a little controversy, but then it's also got some worship. So give us your thoughts. Yes, sir.
Man, this record is so awesome. I hadn't done a Christmas record in my entire career. Can you believe that, Clary?
You have
not. So a lot of my supporters, they want that. And when Zaytoven called me, I was like, man, let's do it. So I went down to Atlanta and we got it done in 1 week.
Wow.
We did it. And that's how you know it was ordained by God. And so there, you know, for me, Clary, the Christmas is not only about Jesus Christ. That's number one. Jesus coming to the earth, God giving us his only son, begotten son, that whosoever believeth, that's number one. But Christmas is also a time of loving, a time of giving, a time of sharing. And for me, it's a time of love, because, you know, I proposed to Dominique on Christmas Day, Christmas
You
morning.
Sure did. I remember I called you on FaceTime and got a chance to see.
Yep.
Yes.
And she said yes, and it was amazing. And so when I think of Christmas, it's a love. It's love is in the air over my house. I don't know what's happening at y'all's house, but around this season, it's mating season.
Who am I?
It's mating season over here for the Haddons in California. and so the other day when I was writing songs for the Christmas album, this song just came to my heart. Let's make love on Christmas. The stars are shining bright to set the moon for you and I. And I wrote it. I was coming back from Aiken, Georgia to Atlanta to catch my flight. And I started singing it, and I sang it to Guy. You know, he's my road manager and Watkins. And he was like, man, that's a hit. And so I just finished it, and Zaytoven loved it. And it came out, when you say, let's make love on Christmas, that's the hook. So the verses got to be a little edgy. And because the song is designed to prepare the atmosphere for making love. That's what the song is for.
That's what
it is. Not to get you into worship. If not to usher you into the holies of holies, well, you're welcome.
It's a different place. It's a different place.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord,
God gets the glory from all these things.
Anyway, it's to prepare you for making love. And so I put a little clip up on my Instagram. Just, I wasn't even thinking about what people's reactions would be. I was just trying to promote and letting people know the record was coming. Before I knew it, all those views and likes, and before I knew it, YouTube, blogs, Deitrick, ad making sex music. I said, come on, y'all. Y'all gotta have more respect for me than that. I put over 20 years of making gospel music, and you're going to disrespect me over one clip of a song. Don't do that. You know I got more intelligence and wisdom than that. Don't treat me like that. And that's one thing I don't like about our genre. We, instead of celebrating people, we like to find little things that we can run with to try to discredit them to build ourselves up. And that's the spirit of jealousy.
Yes.
And I don't like, you know, and it's running rapid in the church. And so a lot of those blogs is really is really motivated by jealousy, and they're trying to build their pages and build their platforms by belittling you, but God is not pleased. And when you do that, you just give God all the more reason to continue to bless me. I'm a blessed man.
That's right.
And so, and to be honest with you, let's be honest, Clarita, after we all speak in tongues, lay hands and cast out devils and shout, we're all, if you're married, you're going to make love at the end of the day.
That's the truth.
Every, even the ones who did the blogs, even the ones that have a problem with it, I'm scratching my head and trying to figure out, how do you have a problem with that? I don't understand it, because you know you're going to make love. Some people are doing it legally and doing it according to the word of God, and some people are not doing it, doing it according to their flesh, you know.
Absolutely.
But you're doing it. And so I don't know why it's so taboo for believers to talk about sex or write a song about it, because it's our truth. It's our reality. And so what I'm trying to get believers to understand is that there are layers to us. We're not just one-dimensional people. Yes, we worship God in spirit and in truth, but yes, we're people that we have emotions, we have feelings, we make love, we're trying to educate ourselves, we get, you know, we have layers to who we are. We have children, we have friends, we have enemies. There's a lot that's going on in our lives, and you mean to tell me we can't sing about it or talk about it?
Yes, I know. It's kind of crazy. Well, let me tell you guys, if you're just tuning in, I'm hanging out with my brother, not just my church brother, not just my covenant brother, but my blood brother, Deitrick Haddon. And we've been having a good time chatting it up about Christmas music, about the church. We've been talking about all kind of stuff. He talked about me in cowboy boots. I mean, but we're still chatting. So welcome to the conversation. We're going to, I can't hold him too long because he's got things to do. But thank you so much for hanging out with me on Blue Flame Moments. We have to make sure that everybody who's listening supports the Greatest Gift Project. Make sure you do what you need to do to support the project. Don't bootleg it. Don't YouTube it. If you watch on YouTube, you listen on YouTube, that's okay, but make sure you purchase the project as well. Please tell us and those that are listening how they can connect with you on social media and how they can get the project.
I'm always on Instagram. That's where I hang out at. I got the blue check there, D Haddy, D-H-A-D-D-Y. You can hit me up on Facebook. I got the blue check there. And Twitter, you can't miss me. I'm out here, y'all. If you want to get that Christmas record, it's going to be available this weekend. And it's going to be some amazing songs that you are going to enjoy. So make sure you get that. And just say a prayer for your brother every time you think about me. Love y'all. Riri, I love you.
Love you too. Thanks so much. Nay, we're getting ready to listen to a Christmas prayer by my brother, Deitrick Haddon. Well, that's our time for now, but this is your destiny coach, Clarita Haddon Jackson, reminding you that there's greatness on the inside of you, and I'm here to help you take your flame from red to blue, because that's what God's anointed me to do. Remember this, you can and you will shine bright and win.